Hey YouTube, my name is Dan and this is a short free extract of my longer course called Animated Infographics and Data Visualization. That course, along with the free exercise files for this particular video and a free downloadable cheat sheet, can be found at bringyourownlaptop.com. Hi there, in this tutorial we're going to look at masking that inner liquid. We're also going to try and do that little liquidy bounce thing that's part of that as well. So let's go and do that now in this tutorial. Alright, the first thing we need to do is open up this exercise file. So go to your exercise files, open up 08 masking. There's one in there called pintglass.aep. That's the After Effects project. Okay, so I've got him open and I've just added some stuff to get us going. Okay, some Illustrator icons. Okay, and what we've got? We've got the middle of our glass, we've got the outside of our glass, and a couple of text layers. Cool. So to get started though, we're not going to need any of those layers. What we're going to do is grab the rectangle tool, make sure we've got nothing selected, okay, and pick a fill color of anything. It can be anything because this is going to be transformed into a mask later on, so it doesn't really matter. Okay, green is just good because it's nice and clear and obvious. The stroke is going to be down to zero. And what we need to do is draw a square or a rectangle that's exactly the same height as this inside liquid here. So it needs to be over the edges a little bit as well. You might have to practice a couple of times. It needs to be kind of like this. Okay, so it's the same height. So I know that that is my 100%. Makes it easy to work out my 53%. And I need a little bit of edges on here. Why? Because I need to use one of my effects in a second called Pucker and Bloat, and it needs a little bit of extra stuff on the side. So maybe not perfectly square like my first one, but maybe something like this, just a little bit taller than it is skinny. Let's rename this layer. Okay, and we're going to call this one Liquid Mask. Next thing we need to do is when we draw a rectangle freehand, okay, you can see the anchor point here has not ended up in the center of the rectangle. It's ended up in the center of the comp. So what we need to do is grab the pan behind tool, okay, and we're going to hold down command on a Mac or control on a PC, click hold and drag this guy here and try to get into the center of this rectangle. Great. Now with liquid mask selected, we're going to adjust the scale. We need to work out what 53% is. Okay, so I'm going to click S for scale and playhead's back at zero. We're going to start the keyframes by clicking the stopwatch. We're going to break the link between the height and the width. And I just want to work with the height and I'm going to make it 53%. So that's my 53% of my glass. Now to make this effect work, we need to drag this a little bit lower. So we're going to go back to my selection tool. Okay, and it needs to be a bit lower. So what I need to do is actually mark where the 53% is. And it's easily done through view. We're going to go to show guides. Okay, and up here in these guides, in this black area here, click, hold, and drag anywhere in this gray black area and line it up with the top of your box. Now when we move it, at least we'll always know where the 53% is. So what we need to do, selection tool, drag it down a little bit. Okay, we just need a bit to cover the bottom. Okay, this effect needs a little bit of extra room around the outside. So the next thing we need to do is we need to get this back up to that line there. So where it says scale, I'm just going to drag it up. Okay, and I know 61% is kind of where it needs to be. So frame one, I've got my keyframes going already. I'm going to start it at zero. Then after some time, okay, 7 frames, we're guessing now. Okay, I'm going to put it back up to 61. So now I know 0 to 61 is going to give me my 53%. Okay, and it's animated, and this could be it. You could just decide that that's perfect. That's all you need to do. Click on middle outlines, switch it to modes, and go track mat. I'd like to use the thing above it, and that's it. That's basically what we're doing, right? But I want to add that kind of like flippity floppity liquid stuff. So I'm going to undo that to go back. Cool. And first of all, well, let's add some easing. Actually, no, let's add the easing later. We're going to have to get it so it's kind of maybe just heading up the glass a little bit. Okay. And then click on liquid mask, twirl it up, twirl it back down to get the full set. And we're going to click add. Now in here, we're going to use this one called pucker and bloat. We've used repeater. We've used trim pass. Okay. We're going to use pucker and bloat now. There it is. Twirl that down. By default, it's bloated out a little bit. Okay, so anything that is positive, if it's negative, it's going to be pucker. Okay, so it's going to get down like that. That's what we kind of want to get started. Okay, and we'll set a keyframe. Actually, let's get it going along till it's just about to get to the top. And you can see here now my pucker is a bit too much because it's actually, I'm starting to see the bottom here. So I'm gonna have to make it a little less. That's it, just so it covers the whole base. Cool. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna set a keyframe for pucker and bloat. And then, okay, maybe just, so what does it go? It goes along there. Okay, so this one needs to be a little bit further, closer to where it kind of stops in terms of scale, maybe just before it. And then just after, we need to go a bit past. So we're gonna go to bloat. How far we're gonna bloat? Okay, eventually you go too far and it starts going back on itself and does weird stuff. Okay, looks like a shamrock. But I'm gonna get it so it goes that far. Cool. And then, okay, so what's that? That is positive 46. So I'm gonna go a few more frames along and then go backwards. Okay, so it goes back again, not fully back. We're just gonna go back a little less every single time. Okay, so we're gonna go back maybe a bit more. Then back this way. We're gonna have to play with the timing loads. I bet you this is gonna look a little naff when I'm finished. Okay. And maybe back to eventually zero where it's flat. We're gonna give this a test run. Don't laugh. Let's see how it goes. All right. It's not my worst. It's not my best either. Before finding yours is terrible, often I've taught this exercise loads, and often if you have a really big first gap, it does look a little funny. Okay, so I'm gonna just separate these all out. Remember, if you wanna expand and contract these, you can select them all, hold down the Alt key on a PC or Option key on a Mac, and they all expand and contract, remember? Just play around until you get a feeling of it. Okay, I feel like that's okay. And what I do find as well is just this first keyframe needs easing. Why? Just because I've played around with it lots, okay? And I know, I feel like if you ease them all, they don't look as good. But if you ease this first one, 75, okay, and it just makes it, I feel it does anyway. Cool, all right. Next thing we need to do is we need to apply it as a mask. So let's twirl this up, and the guy underneath, he needs to be directly underneath this middle outlines of our mask. So click on this guy, make sure we're on modes and not switches. And on the track mat, who are we gonna say? We're gonna say the guy just above him called Liquid Mask is gonna be my mask, please. Kick back and, it could be better. It's okay. Okay, so that is the pucker and bloat. Okay, so we've used the mask, okay, which is kind of cool. And we also use that pucker and bloat. I now probably, if I was gonna do it again, I might make the pucker and the bloat maybe a bit more, okay, it doesn't kind of go enough for me. It's okay. What we also might do is, let's just check to see, let's go back to modes, turn on motion blur, let's just check to see if it's any good with a bit of motion blur. It does look better. My timing's not quite there though. All right, that is gonna be it for this exercise. Let's get on to the next tutorial. Hey there, what'd you think? If you like the video, hit the like button, that'd be great. Also consider subscribing to my channel. Now this is a free part of a longer course. You can check that out on bringyourownlaptop.com. On that site is a free downloadable printable PDF cheat sheet, okay, to help you with your infographics and data visualization. Also on that site is a bunch of other courses as well. So go check it out, bringyourownlaptop.com. Bye now.